The two soldiers, according to Major General Olum, died at Kasindi near the Uganda-Congo border of Mpondwe. However, Major General Olum says the losses that Uganda has suffered cannot be equated to the strides made in the operation so far. According to him, 23 ADF terrorists have been put out of action on the battlefield from the month of July to date.
And we lost two soldiers in October in Kasindi. But from September, August up to July, we didn't lose any soldiers. From November, the beginning of November up to now, we have not lost any soldiers. But from July up to October, we killed more than 23 ADF. So that means the ADF loses more. We also lose a few soldiers, but not as many as we do with the ADF.
General Olum says a few other soldiers have suffered bullet wounds and are undergoing treatment and insists that the losses that Uganda has incurred in the Eastern Congo battle are very minimal.
Cases we get injuries from bullet wounds, but that's after a long time. So our losses are not like the ones of the ADF, no. Otherwise, Ugandans would have got alarmed. They would be seeing dead bodies flying left and right. And anyway, whose son are you going to bury without his parents getting to know his wife, his family?
The Operation Shujaa is a jungle battle which is being fought in one of the biggest forests within the Ituri province. General Olum says that the jungle battle has presented its unique challenges to the joint forces.
Come into a country where infrastructure is not as easy as you would see it back home in Uganda. We are in one of the biggest forests in the world. And this is a very thick ground without communication networks, without infrastructure roads, without essentials of services. So that's what really pushes us to work harder jointly with the Congolese military to ensure we clear off the...
Without disclosing much details, Major General Olum told the news that a lot of support is needed for the ongoing Operation Shujaa.
We have a lot that we receive, but there's still a lot that is required. That is tactical, which I would have mentioned. Military requirements, which I wouldn't want to tell you, so a lot. We need a lot of support.
The joint operation was launched in 2021 with codenamed Operation Shujaa. It is being undertaken by both the Uganda People's Defense Forces and the Armed Forces of the Democratic Republic of Congo. Reports compiled by Roger Sunday for the news.